BRB Blazer.
So we jump into the next guy right here. Got Cooper Kupp at number 7. I actually have Cooper Kupp ranked number 7 right here. I'm not sure where you guys have him.
I think I have him.
I have him at 8.
I had him at like 6 or 7. I ended up moving down to 9.
Yeah. 8. I love Cooper Kupp. He's another guy in another contract year. So if he wants to get paid, I mean, he's going to have to go out there and put up or shut up, like I said. I mean, and it's kind of like Jared Goff's right-hand guy, you know, kind of his, you know, security blanket. Finished as the wide receiver 4 last year in half-point PPR. He had the 11th most targets, 7th most receptions. Kind of a nose for the end zone, I was thinking. You know, in his rookie year, 5 touchdowns. You know, that was a rookie year with Goff. 6 the next year, 10 last year. So kind of, you know, when they get in the end, when they get in that red zone area, they do look for him. And you heard me say with Godwin, you know, the completion percentage when he was targeted, Cooper Kupp had a 70% completion percentage. That was 4th best in the NFL. So when him and Goff are connecting, they're connecting at a high rate. I think, you know, the departure of Brandon Cooks, you know, no Gurley, that a couple targets should funnel his way as well. So I think he'll be another guy where he's a consistent, safe guy for you each and every week, where he's going to get the volume, and then, you know, he gets utilized in the red zone as well.
Couldn't agree more. As you say that, I was actually, you know what, Mike? You go, bro. Fuck that.
Why?
I don't know.
I have Cooper Kupp ranked pretty low, actually, compared to
I'm a little worried. Guys. Go ahead, Mike. After you.
I mean, okay. I don't like, honestly, I don't know what's gonna happen with Cooper Kupp this year. He is super reliable, so like I had to put him in my top 12 for sure. But I did, like, obviously we saw the use of tight ends towards the end of the season, which we used to joke about that the Rams never use a tight end. But
yeah,
you saw Higbee being super used, and who else was it? Henderson or no?
Gerald Everett.
Gerald Everett. Excuse me. So yeah, like it's hard for me to say. I will say, if you're in a full point PPR league, he does seem to be like the Julian Edelman type of guy that's just going to catch small passes and just for whatever yard, for a short amount of yardage, you know. But yeah, so I had to put him in the top 12, but I wasn't sure exactly where to put him, so I have him at 10. Yeah. I don't know how you guys feel.
All righty, man, go ahead.
I'm losing. I'm trying to look up the stat. It's just hard on the phone.
One thing I was gonna say too is, like, they got rid of Brandon Cooks. Obviously, you know, he was due like $12 million, I think, or something like that. Cooper Kupp, he's only making like $1 million this year. I say only $1 million again. I think it's nothing, but they're obviously gonna sign him to a long term contract extension. That's Jared Goff's boy. They came in the league at the same time. If you paid attention, you know, when we first started the podcast, you know, they were actually roommates during the whole training camp and like spring training or whatever you call it. Process. So, you know, they're like best friends. So you sign Goff to this mega contract extension, he's making like 100+ million. It's only right that they're going to sign Cooper Kupp to an extension as well. So depending on how well he plays is depending on how much he could be another guy where he's making, you know, 10-12 million a year next year. So, and if he can get you 85 to 90 receptions and 7-8 touchdowns, I mean, I think that's would be a solid guy right there for you.
Do you, well, okay, so like Brandon Cooks is leaving, but does that mean that those, like, there is he had 42 receptions last year, but to me it's like, I don't think that those, I think those Brandon Cooks targets are different than the Cooper Kupp targets, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I feel like Brandon Cooks is a different type of receiver, so like I don't know if those targets are going to go straight to Cooper Kupp, or are they going to go to, are, is Josh Reynolds going to be used more, is that more of a boost for Josh Reynolds, or, you know what I mean? I think I do agree, though. Cooper Kupp is going to – he does seem to have, like, a huge rapport with Jared Goff. But what do you guys think, Anthony?
Yeah, I'm kind of like, on your side a little bit more. I do have some concerns with Cooper Kupp. Like you said, the offense, it shifted. Like, we were joking about tight ends, but it became not a joke anymore. You know, after week 9, the targets for Cooper Kupp, 4, and I had him too. So it's like, it was like he was a beast for like the first like 8 weeks. It was like fucking, oh, Cooper Kupp, just plug and play, fucking touchdown every week. And then it just changed. And Brandon, it's not like Brandon Cooks wasn't there. He was still there. Or not, he was there, but he wasn't getting like heavily involved. It was, you know, in the same time as this, you know, 4 targets, 2 targets is Cook. So he wasn't even really highly involved at that point. It was the tight end position that took over. But get back to Cooper Kupp. From week 9 forward, his targets 4, 3, 10, 6, 4, 6, 4, 10. I don't like seeing that 4, 3, 4, 6. Like, that's just a little worrisome. The offense shifted. Like, it's like a tale of two halves. So it's like I'm trying to make what I can out of this. Wide receiver 5, this was what I was trying to pull up. In the first 9 weeks in 5-point PPR, wide receiver 5. The last 9 weeks, wide receiver 31.
Oh, yeah.
So that's a huge difference. So I don't think he's a new wide receiver 31, obviously, but I am taking some of that. That second half of the season, I feel like, could it be a fluke? Potentially, but it's kind of raising my eyebrows, and I do have to look into these numbers, and you know, the draft's going to play a role in this, but I'm potentially a little worried about, like, the Rams in general, which is not making me feel the best about Cooper Kupp. I think the Rams could be headed for a down year this year, so I have him at 8 or 9 right now, but he might slide down in my rankings once we get closer to season. If there's some numbers I look through and I'm liking what I see in the Rams, and a little bit worried about Cooper Kupp, to be honest.
What do you think, Dre?
I mean, I have him at 8, so I actually had him higher, and then I moved him down one. So I looked up. There's 121 targets are gone with Gurley and Cooks. Not catches, just targets. So him and Robert Woods are the alpha. I mean, like I said, you can do the own math. You figure they're going to get 30 of those each. I mean, you can whatever, however you want to do it. But I feel they're going to be more of a pass oriented team, and I think they're not going to be as good as far as like regular record, I don't think. But I think they're going to put up more points because they lost a lot of guys on defense. So I think they're going to be airing it out more. They don't have Gurley. They don't have like that guy they're like feel forced to give the ball to, like, out of the backfield. And McVay is a creative dude. So I think he's going to find ways to scheme these guys open. I mean, he still has Robert Woods, who's super, super gadget type guy. He gets like, he was getting like what he led the NFL, like, rushing yards for receivers. He would always be getting those end around yards. Yeah.
He actually had more targets than Cooper Kupp last year.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, so a lot of people, he's like a sneaky 1A, but Cooper Kupp and Goff have that chemistry.
That's what I was going to ask too. Like, are you done? Sorry,
I mean, no, I mean, I'm almost. I mean, he had 100 and some. What do you have? 130 targets last year.
135.
So, with 120 up for grabs, of course, the emergence of Tyler Higbee is going to help. You have Gerald Everett if they want to use, you know, the double tight. You have Josh Reynolds, who has been there for 4 years. They drafted him out of A&M. So, but he's still the best guy. So you're still going to get, you're going to find ways to get your best guys the ball. And I just think he's their best guy as long as he stays healthy, which is everybody else. So yeah. I think you
see, here's where I like, just like, cause I have always heard the targets up for grabs. Like, this is just me starting to do fantasy football back in the day. It's like 120 up for grabs. So it's like, yeah, it was 120. But last year, let's just look at the Rams, for example. There were 60 targets to the running back. The running back position in general is still going to get targets, whether it's 60, whether it's 80, 90. That's up to next year. So it's like you got to look at like the passing game pie and figure that, yeah, it was 120 technically up for grabs, but that running back position is going to pull away at least half that 120. Now it's like, you know, he did have 134 targets last year, which was pretty solid. You know, you take those other 60, they're still going to have a wide receiver on 3 on the team taking up targets. So it's how much work is actually up for grabs from last year to me. I don't think it's that much. But the other question I was going to ask is, do you think Robert Woods is the guy to target? Because it's like we talk about these situations with Cooper and Gallup, and sometimes, you know, the Diggs and Thielen, where it's like there might not be much of a difference in production. But, I mean, I think –
you're getting a guy. You get Woods, and like, later.
What do you think? Maybe the 5th right now. I feel like he's.
I have Woods in my top 20, so I think these guys finish in the top 20 at least.
So that's kind of what I'm thinking. Is it more of like the same situation like we were discussing last night? Is Woods the guy that's going to end up? I'm going to have him most of my teams because I'm not going to potentially reach and just sit on Woods if I'm getting him in the 5th or 6th. Yeah. Who could actually have the better year just based off of close targets and, you know, if he happens to fall in the end zone by chance more. So that was just my question with that part.
Yeah, no, I agree 100%. Yeah, you know, there's a lot of these receivers, like, say, 1A, 1B, and I'll just wait a couple rounds
for the 1B.
And grab the 1B.
Yeah.
Just depends what you like.
Yeah. It's like an Odell Landry situation, too. It's like, you know, like we were saying, I'd rather take Landry later.
For sure, yeah. I mean, I know the targets, like you said, 134. It was 11th most in the league. So you got to think that that's kind of his baseline.
Yeah, that's what I
mean. I don't think it goes any lower. Does he get more? Maybe he gets more, but I think it stays around there, 135, 140, 145 ish, you know? So I think as long as he gets those targets, you know, and the touchdowns, you know, even if he gets like 7-8 touchdowns, he finished wide receiver 4 last year, he should get you top 12 numbers, you know, at least a back end wide receiver 1. If anything, you know, if you draft him and he's your second wide receiver, I think you're going to be stoked to just have him as like your second wide receiver.